I'm very happy to be coming with you today on this broadcast. You know, I'm so glad for Jesus Christ and what he means in my life. And I thank you for all of you that are listening. If you don't know Jesus, this would be a good day to accept him as your Savior because he's coming again. I want to share a scripture with you in 1 Corinthians 15 and 58. Be ye therefore steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For in as much as you know that your labor for the Lord is not in vain. For those of you that may be despairing or feeling bad or faint-hearted about what you're doing for the Lord, let me tell you something. God is going to reward you for everything you do. Jesus even talked about giving a cup of water in his name. You'll be rewarded for it. You may not be preaching before many people. You may not be standing before people. You may do a very a job that you don't feel like you're doing much good in, but people watch our life and let our light so shine that people may see Jesus in us and glorify the Father which is in heaven. So do not despair. Your relationship with God is a great thing, and you can carry on the work of God and do the things he wants you to do. And I want to encourage you today, be steadfast in your faith. Don't let anything move you from what you believe. We have a lot of things going on in our nation today. There's a lot of people that will try to, our churches have been closed down, and it seemed like the old devil, there's one thing that he'd like to do is he'd like to close down every church in this world. Folks, I want to tell you, the Bible says that Jesus said in up on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. So the church is going to live. I'm not exactly talking about a building. I'm talking about believers that really believe in God with all of their heart. So be steadfast, unmovable. Don't let anything move you. Don't let other people's opinions or anything despair you and cause you to do things that you lose your faith in. I was listening to a quote by a professor, a well-known professor, I won't call his name, but he said more or less in essence that if you believe in eternity and life after death, that you were delusional or something along that line. Folks, I want to tell you, the Apostle Paul was preaching to people that did not believe in the resurrection. And that's why he quoted this scripture here to tell you to be steadfast, unmovable. Regardless of people that didn't believe in the resurrection, the Apostle Paul used the whole chapter 15 of 1 Corinthians to teach people the benefit of what it means to be resurrected. And we're going to be resurrected one of these days when we serve him. Unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Everything you can do for the Lord, even if it's just a small, minute thing in your own mind, God's going to reward you for everything you do. He's going to see everything we do, and he does that without a doubt. He sees every prayer we pray. I want to encourage you today to get a hold of that unchanging hand that gives you strong, strong encouragement today to go on for the Lord. Inasmuch as we know that our labor for the Lord is not in vain. Whatever you think you're doing, anything you're doing for the Lord is not in vain. There's going to be a time, it's called the judgment seat of Christ, where we're going to receive rewards for what we've done in this life. And if you do things for God, it's going to be rewarded. And oh, thank God, if you just clean up a church and don't get paid for it, you're going to be blessed. If you take somebody some food that needs it, you're going to be blessed. Thank the Lord for that. I like the scripture. I also want to read you a scripture as I'm looking at my Bible now, and it's found in Galatians 6 and 9. And let us not go weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. So I want to encourage you today, there is life after death. I don't care what that professor says, there is life after death. I'm going to stand by what the Word of God says. I'm going to hold on to what God's Word tells us. Hold firm in your faith. Don't let anyone move you. Don't let any situation or what anybody quotes and says it's not real. Heaven is real. God is real. We've got serving a real bad devil. He's really after all of us. and come to grips with the fact that you can walk with God in the beauty of His holiness and live for Him. And when that day comes, when we go home, we're going to rejoice greatly. Thank you so much. I appreciate all of you in Africa and those in Uganda, all of those that are listening to me all around the world, all my friends and my family. Thank you so much. Please do some comments and likes on this if you like this video. It's certainly appreciated, and I read every one of them. Thank you very much for listening today. God bless you richly.